Creek, Bessie Bound Mountain Park Restoration Project Bid Award Recommendation. March 19, 2018, proposals, bids were received for the Griswold Creek Restoration Project. They were from the following, from lowest to highest. First was Applied Ecological Services at $241,433. The next was Davy Resource Group at $241,798. The next was Partners Environmental Engineering and Surveying Firm at $245,500. And the last was River Reach Construction and Bioscience and GPD Group at $253,765. March 22, 2018, Christina Zendarsik, the Associate Director with Sugar River Watershed Partners, Alicia Beatty, the Senior Project Manager, and Paul met in order to discuss and evaluate the proposals. Proposals were evaluated based on quality of the approach plan, qualifications of staff, experience, deliverables, comprehensiveness of the solution, and cost. This is a not to exceed contract with the maximum amount allowable for design and construction at $253,765. So based upon a standardized scoring matrix criteria, Davy Resource Group was selected by all the reviewers as the lowest and best. Therefore, it is our recommendation that the Board of Park Commissioners accept this bid and award the contract to Davy Resource Group for the Griswold Creek Restoration Project. So, I'll entertain a motion, bring it to the table.
So moved.
Okay. Right. Any other questions about the request within this project?
Have we ever worked with Davy before?
We've utilized that.
Davy Kent?
Well, Davy Resource Group is part of Davy Tree, but it's actually a separate kind of consulting firm. But we've worked with them on quite a bit of invasive species control in the past. They do a lot of design build restoration work.
And you've always been satisfied with their work, I'm assuming?
Mm-hmm.
I know it's only a few hundred dollars difference, but why did you make the decision versus Davy versus Applied?
Well, I can speak to that.
Sure.
So Davy addressed a lot more of the wetland concerns that we had surrounding the stream, whereas the other proposals really didn't include a lot of wetland design into the preliminary.
What were some of your concerns?
Well, we wanted to actually create some more wetland habitat for the pools, amphibian, reptile habitat around the stream itself. More than what's there right now.
So frogs and fish, right?
Right, frogs, salamanders, turtle habitat, things like that around the stream. And, the lowest bid did not mention any of that at all.
Good. Is it all requested in the bid package?
Yeah, we talked about it after we had a pre-bid meeting where everyone was present there, and we spoke to that.
Any questions? Okay. Motion on the table, we have a second. So this is a not-to-exceed contract, as I mentioned, not-to-exceed $253,765. But we'll go ahead and call the vote. First up, Mr. Bates.
Yes.
And Mr. Law.
Yes.
All right, thank you. Next up is a motion to award for the on March 15, 2018, five lump sum bids were received for the Ellerin property improvement project. And the corresponding bid awards are accompanying in the board packet. The parent low bidder is Cold Harbor Building Company with a base bid of $1,145,946.15, which is within the budget amount of $1,176,000. It is recommended that the Board of Park Commissioners accept the bid from Cold Harbor Building Company for $1,145,946.15 for the Elrin property improvements. This recommendation is based on the review by both AECOM and the Planning Department, included in the attachment memo and after checking their references. So I would entertain a motion to bring it to the table for discussion and questions.
Second.
Questions about our parent low bidder awarding the contract to Cold Harbor?
Well, I'd like to ask a question regarding the, what we do with Bainbridge. When we were negotiating or discussing these matters with Bainbridge, we submitted to them all of the information, documents, plans, so forth. So anything that would have normally been included in a application with the township was included, so they did receive all the information that they needed to make a decision.
I mean, actually, yeah, we gave the package.
We gave them the full construction drawing set up of plans. So it was roughly 50 sheets.
So in some ways, it would have exceeded.
Yeah.
But there's only an application sought as information.
Okay. And it's clear that if we're, as a separate public entity, we do not have to do.
We did not. The course has been clear that a separate political entity, such as a park, under chapter 14, 1545, is not required to go through the formal application process of the township.
But in our efforts to maintain good relationships with the community in which we are a significant participant in their existence, we did everything we could.
I think we were as candid and forthright as we could be.
Other questions? Okay. Call the vote. Award the Elrin improvement projects to Cold Harbor. Mr. Law.
Yes.
And Mr. Bates.
Yes.
Next up is budget amendment number 5, resolution 518. At this time, a supplemental appropriation is being requested to increase appropriations for the Elrin property improvement project for the purchase of a concrete restroom. Current budget is $1,176,000. The amendment is $50,000. So the amended budget will be $1,226,000. I will entertain a motion, and then we will take questions and discussion.
Second.
This is like an important precast?
Yes. One of the places we have them, we have them in Bass Lake. I don't think we have them.
Headwater, Walter C. Best. They're the precast CXT kind of concrete restrooms. We've kind of moved towards using those over the textile ones because they're a little bit more sort of
sturdy,
a little easier to take care of and maintain, and you can clean them, power wash them, and, you know, it's not going to hurt anything.
Is that generally the cost of that that unit?
Yeah, they're about, with this particular unit, I think they're right at like $46,000 for the actual unit itself.
Now, do we have to build a roof on those, or do they come completely assembled?
The unit comes completely assembled, and then basically the hole has to be dug, and then they'll come out, and they set it on site, and the electric has to be built on.
Sure.
Other questions? I'll call a vote. Here's some money. Mr. Law.
Yes.
And Mr. Bates.
Yes.
Next up is surplus property. At the last minute, we had an additional item that was not included in the original board packet. That is the addition of a truck. costing them that truck, and we looked at the replacement value and offered, so we think it's reasonable trade-in on a truck that is 10 years old.
So we kind of discussed at the last board meeting, the plow trucks and kind of our winners. This is actually a 2000.